Greetings of the day. Today's article for Journal Club, Cardiovascular Effects of Psychotic Illnesses and Antipsychotic Therapy. This is a review article taken from British Heart Journal. Presenter myself, Prof. Seetala, and moderator is Dr. Karthik Rao. Introduction. Mental health and cardiovascular disorders have been greatest medical challenges to well-being. Important mental health disorders include schizophrenia, severe stress, anxiety, bipolar disorder, and severe depression. Mortality from cardiovascular disease increased in people with mental health disorders in general and schizophrenia in particular. Causes are multifactorial, but it is known that antipsychotic medication can cause cardiac side effects beyond the traditional coronary risk factors which may be pre-existing in a patient. This article comprises a review of schizophrenia and the circulation, the impact of metabolic syndrome in the overall cardiovascular risk in schizophrenia, the role of autonomic dysfunction, biological and genetic links, effects of antipsychotic medication on the heart, including arrhythmias and pharmacogenetic considerations, clozapine and cardiomyopathy, prevention of cardiovascular complications. Schizophrenia and the circulation. Cardiovascular disease has been a leading cause of death in patients with schizophrenia. Large-scale meta-analysis showed that schizophrenia was significantly associated with cardiovascular disease. Cardiovascular mortality rates are increasing in schizophrenia, likely due to under-recognition of cardiovascular disease and associated risk factors. Metabolic syndrome. The prevalence of metabolic syndrome is increased in people with schizophrenia. Studies suggest severe mental illnesses and metabolic syndrome share pathophysiological features, some of which are hypothalamic pituitary adrenal and mitochondrial dysfunction, neuroinflammation, common genetic links, and epigenetic interactions. Autonomic dysfunction. The left hemisphere mainly controls the sympathetic function and the right hemisphere controls the parasympathetic function. In schizophrenia, there is sympathetic and parasympathetic imbalance, which is responsible for cardiac autonomic dysfunction. There are disturbances in cortico-subcortical circuits which modulate the autonomic nervous activity, and all these factors lead to reduced vagal activity, which cause increased resting heart rate, elevated blood pressure, reduced baroreceptor sensitivity, reduced vagal thresholds during exercise, and all these cause cardiac autonomic dysfunction. They reduce life expectancy and reduced physical fitness. Biological and genetic links. They are believed to be existing between cardiovascular death and schizophrenia. These links have been suggested on basis of genome-wide association studies and data based on genetic pleiotropy. The findings suggest that shared biological and genetic mechanisms might help explain why schizophrenia patients have greater risk of cardiovascular disease. Antipsychotic medications and the heart. ECG abnormalities are well known in people using antipsychotic medications, which include widening of QRS complex, QT prolongation, ST depression, abnormal T-wave morphology, and large U-waves. And these ECG abnormalities are very common, the prevalence being 25%. Rayleigh et al. Found a point prevalence of 8% for QT prolongation, and this prevalence increases with the dosage of the drug, age, and concomitant use of tricyclic antidepressants. The Royal College of Psychiatrists also reported association between antipsychotic drugs and sudden cardiac death. Review by Carl et al. Highlighted the importance of antipsychotic polypharmacy, especially in the elderly. Polypharmacy increases the risk of arrhythmias via QT prolongation. Mechanisms of arrhythmia. Antipsychotic drugs had an analogous effects on cardiac conduction similar to class 1A antiarrhythmic drugs. The mechanisms include sodium channel blockade, decrease in the rate of rise of phase 0 potential of action, phase 0 of action potential, decreased slope of phase 4 spontaneous depolarization. The molecular studies also established a structural basis for drug-induced QT prolongation. There is inhibition of delayed rectifier potassium channels, which are known as human ether AGOGO-related gene-encoded potassium channel, in short HERG. Both depolarization and repolarization are prolonged as a result, and there is QRS and QT prolongation. Pharmacogenetic considerations. Antipsychotic medications and unfavorable genetic profile can be a very lethal combination. Abnormalities of single cardiac ion channel coding genes include hereditary long QT syndrome, Brugada syndrome, catecholaminergic polymorphic VT, and idiopathic atrial fibrillation. Salvo and colleagues, after meta-analysis of observational studies in 2015, to assess the mortality rate of 9 individual antipsychotics. And they found the higher the potency of HERG blockade resulted in higher mortality risk, likely attributable to its QT prolonging properties. The incidence rate per 1000 person years was highest for thioridazine, which was 5.1. Heterogenic risk exists for different antipsychotics attributable to the potency of HERG blockade of the drug. Some of the newer antipsychotic agents and their associated coronary risk is a table depicting the cardiovascular side effects of antipsychotic medication. For all atypical antipsychotics, QT prolongation, arrhythmia, hypotension are common cardiovascular side effects, and less frequently they can cause sudden cardiac death. Haloperidol can cause QT prolongation and dose-dependent hypotension. Clorpromazine at an unknown frequency causes AV block, sudden cardiac death, hypertriglyceridemia. Risperidone can cause AV block, QT prolongation, palpitations, postural hypotension, and syncope. Aripiprazole cardiovascular side effects include angina, sudden cardiac death, hypertension, and syncope. Olanzapine can cause dyslipidemia, that is with IMUs. Clozapine cardiovascular effects include myocarditis, cardiomyopathy, sudden cardiac death, dyslipidemia, pericardial effusion, and at an unknown frequency can cause angina, myocardial infarction, and QT prolongation. The mechanism of clozapine-induced myocarditis will be discussed later. Quetiapine can cause palpitations and syncope. Clozapine-induced myocarditis and cardiomyopathy. This is not dose-dependent, and the onset is 3 weeks to 4 years. Most occurs between 6 to 9 months of initiation. The mechanism: decreased parasympathetic drive, increased sympathetic drive, which will cause tachycardia at rest. This impairment of left ventricular function. There is enzyme deficiency of cytochrome P450, 1A2 and 1A3. Calcium channel blockade. Increased inflammatory cytokines. Treatment: early cessation of clozapine will help because LV dysfunction is reversible. Mechanism of clozapine-induced myocarditis and cardiomyopathy. This type 1 IgE-mediated acute hypersensitivity reaction, which leads to peripheral eosinophilia, eosinophilic myocardial infiltrates, raised cardiac myeloperoxidase levels. There's release of reactive oxygen species and cytotoxic proteins, which cause tissue injury, necrosis, and as a result, myocarditis. Prevention: carefully observe patients for symptoms like breathlessness, palpitations, and fatigue. Active monitoring for 4 weeks, predominantly troponin and C-reactive protein. Cardiac biomarkers routinely should be done: creatine kinase, troponin, and BNP. And echocardiography, pre-screening, and serial assessment every 6 months. Prevention of cardiovascular disease in general. The RAISE ATP study has considered the prevalence of cardiovascular risk factors in patients treated for schizophrenia prior to and after treatment to establish the influence of antipsychotics on cardiovascular risk factors. They have found that brief antipsychotic exposure was associated with a significant effect of antipsychotic treatment duration in disturbing lipid metabolism. In this context, the European Psychiatric Association has advised physical exercise and conventional risk factor management in these patients. This table shows studies reporting cardiovascular outcomes in patients taking antipsychotic medication. Ray et al. Did a retrospective cohort study on a population of 480,000 whose endpoint was considered as sudden cardiac death. And he found out that patients with pre-existing severe cardiovascular disease had a 1.2-fold higher risk of arrhythmic death on typical antipsychotics. Another study Longitudinal case control study done by Strauss et al. Showed that there was a threefold increase in sudden cardiac death in patients on antipsychotics, and male patients were twice as likely to be affected. Park et al. Did a cohort study on post-MI in patients treated for delirium and agitation with antipsychotics, and the endpoint of the study was arrhythmic events or sudden cardiac death during hospital stay within 7 days. They found out that there was increased risk of death for haloperidol in comparison to olanzapine, quetiapine and risperidone. Another study, Finnish genetic study for arrhythmic events, whose endpoint was considered sudden cardiac death post-acute MI, and they found out that the use of antipsychotics was higher in the sudden cardiac death group and resulted in a 4.3-fold higher mortality during acute MI than their counterparts. Lin et al. Did a retrospective case control study. He studied ECGs from schizophrenia patients versus controls. And the predictive factors for QT prolongation were female gender, old age, and treatment with clozapine, thioridazine, chlorpromazine, and sulfuride. Take-home messages. The treatment with typical and atypical antipsychotics. In these patients, we should monitor electrolyte disturbances, especially if the patient is on diuretics. Always perform a baseline ECG and monitor QT interval. Check family history to exclude any underlying hereditary channelopathies or conduction disorders which are present prior to the treatment. Monitor glycated HB levels and lipid levels. Additional advice. In addition to drug treatment, monitor cardiovascular risk factors, monitor weight, encourage weight loss, dietary advice, advise to take high protein and low fat diet, monitor the blood pressure regularly, encourage exercise independent of the cardiovascular risk factors, and if the patient is a smoker, advise cessation of smoking. And if any signs of concurrent depression are noticed, then better to advise cognitive behavioral therapy to minimize polypharmacy. And especially in patients taking clozapine, always a baseline echo has to be performed prior to the treatment. And any follow-up should be done for anginal symptoms, persistent tachycardia, dyspnea, peripheral edema, or any other signs of cardiomyopathy or cardiac failure. And if any of these are present, treatment should be ceased. Thank you.